Dear friends, welcome back. Today we take a look at rotary encoders using Arduino. A rotary encoder, this device here, is an electro-mechanical device that converts angular position or rotation of a shaft into analog or digital code. In simple words, when I turn this shaft to the right, it increases its value, and when I turn it to the left, it decreases its value. The main advantage of the rotary encoders is that I can turn them unlimited times. So, this rotary encoder has 20 positions. Let's look. We are now at position 10, so the value is 10. Let's go back to position 0 by turning it to the right. You can see the value is 20 and I can still turn it to the right and the value increases. When I turn it to the left, the value decreases and the position decreases as well. Rotary encoders are used in many applications that require precise shaft and limited rotation, like industrial control, robotics, or computers and microcontrollers, like the projects that we are building. Another very useful feature of this rotary encoder is that it has a button embedded. As you can see, I can click the rotary encoder and Arduino recognizes the click and shows clicked message here. I can hold it pressed, and as you can see, it is now showing held, and when I release it, it shows released. So it is very useful, except from a rotary encoder, it can act as a button. Very, very useful in many, many projects. Now, let's see how to connect a rotary encoder to an Arduino project. First of all, let's take a look at the module that we are going to use. We are going to use this module that we bought from eBay for around 1 or 2 euros that consists of a rotary encoder that has 20 positions and it can be clicked. As you can see, I can press it and it can be clicked. So, in the back it has some passive components and it consists of 5 pins. Now, let's see how to connect this module to an Arduino. We are using an Arduino Mega here. First of all, we have to connect the ground. Ground pin goes to Arduino ground, of course. The second pin is power. So power connects to the 5 volts of the Arduino. 5 volts input, output is here. The third pin of the rotary encoder is named SW. SW pin is going to analog pin 2 in the Arduino. The fourth pin is named DT. DT goes to analog pin 1. And lastly, the clock pin goes to analog pin 0. Now we are ready to connect the LCD display, the Nokia 5110 LCD display, and see the result. If you want to see how to connect the Nokia 5110 LCD display, check out our previous video. Okay, we have just connected the LCD screen. Let's see if it is working. I power on the Arduino board and it is working. When I turn the shaft to the right, it increases the value, and when I turn to the left, it decreases. Now, let's see the code of the project. In order to use the rotary encoder module, we have to download 2 more libraries other than the Nokia 5110 display library used in driving the LCD display. The first library that we have to download is the click encoder library that you can see here from 0xpit. You can download it from GitHub, and you can find the link in the description of the video. So, we download this zip and we unzip it and rename it to rotary encoder. And then we cut it and paste it to Arduino libraries folder. That's it. Next, we have to download the timer1 library from Paul Stoffregen. This is an important library that without this the project won't work. We download the zip as well and we unzip it in the libraries folder as well and rename it to timer1, for example. Now we are ready to open up Arduino. Arduino IDE is now open and I have loaded the encoder Nokia sketch. You can download this sketch from the description of the video. As you can see, the code is based in a click encoder example that you can find in the click encoder library. All I have done is I made some changes and implemented the LCD display. At this point, I would like to thank the authors of the libraries that we are using because they make our lives easier. Without those libraries, it will take us days in order to develop a project like this. So, a big thanks to all the guys that develop those amazing libraries. Thank you. So, that's how you can connect a Rotary encoder in your Arduino project using a library. It is very fast and easy, and as you can see, very useful as well. We are going to use this Rotary encoder module in future projects because it is very useful. The first project in which we are going to use it is the old radio MP3 conversion that is ongoing. We are going to use this Rotary encoder to control volume of the MP3 player. More about this in the future videos. If you liked our video, press like in the button below or subscribe to our channel to watch our next videos. Thank you very much.